Hello, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales. Blind, I'm the RPG check. So, current state of affairs, Wilbur got stuck in a trap and is taken away to the orc camp. We've got a couple undead friends in there who the paladin is an enemy of. I guess we're going to try to convince him to let the guy out of his manacles, or pillory, whatever you call it, in exchange. Maybe they'll help us at the orc camp, possibly.
A head on a pole. What will the Peggy people have to say about that?
Who are the Peggy people?
A gruesome head. Kind of a cheap gimmick, because ultimately...
Ooh!
Ah!
What? What? Is there a spider on me?
There's a pole on you.
No.
Oh, thank goodness. Those creepy crawlies drive me mad. Can you imagine what it feels like when they run up your neck and then start nibbling at your eyes from the inside?
No, I can't imagine that at all. Ergs.
You can say that again. It's not nice. Damn paladin. Simply chops my head off.
Hey, stop that nattering. Leave the head alone.
Leave the head alone. Leave the head alone.
That you, Esther? I've just met your body. It's doing okay,
right,
apart from missing its head.
I miss her. I would love to write, but no hands.
Shh! Quiet over there!
She needs presents. Oh.
Hello.
Woohoo!
I just wanted to...
Hey! I said no talking to the prisoner.
Oh.
Hello.
Woohoo!
I just...
Hey!
Oh.
Alright, let's look at this paper.
A map of the region. Among other things, the paladin has marked the crypt.
I'll be taking that right in front of you.
A map of the region. Among other things...
Great art. Great art, let me tell you. The crypt, then. Oh, is there a dragon up there? That'd be cool. Maybe that's where that one dragon landed.
A fashionable travel chest made from light wood. There's a logo on it. The Pink Crusaders. He's not looking right now. Why not? You can always use a pink-colored pom-pom.
Seriously?
In the wildlands. In the war. There was nothing else of any interest in it.
Why is
not
the pink...
Not that I'd find pom-poms interesting.
Exactly.
Why not? You can always use a pink-colored pom-pom. In the wild... In...
Pennant?
A banner. The emblem on it could be the paladin's arms. It shows a sword, a shield, and... red high heels?
Red high heels? What do you have red heels for?
A banner.
What are these presents? Look at the hard red earth. One thing to look at that.
Some red earth. Just about everything else here is black and gray.
Okay, we took some.
Some...
Oh, mushrooms?
A few small white mushrooms. No idea if you can eat them.
Hmm.
A few small white...
Oh, look at the damp ground.
The paladin always spits in this place. The ground is already sodden.
Figure he's not the spitting type.
The paladin all...
To look at him.
A paladin in a pink-colored outfit? That's wrong. Just wrong.
Talk to him?
Are you a warrior?
No, I can't fight.
Are you a healer?
I can't heal either.
Then you're a paladin.
Huh. What do you want?
You know any good paladin jokes?
Know any good paladin jokes?
Why should anyone make jokes about us? We are the holy soldiers of the light.
In dresses?
This is a tunic.
Sure.
What kind of clothing... You know what kind of clothing men usually wear?
You know that men who wear dresses are, as a rule, well, men who wear dresses.
What's that supposed to mean? Just because I wear dresses, use cosmetics, and take a general interest in my appearance.
He uses cosmetics.
Ah, so it is a dress.
The modern man is metrosexual.
That's news to me.
Well, my order and I have lifted ourselves up out of the mud in which you and your sort still wallow like pigs. We're cosmopolitan, hip, fashionable. We take care of our appearance and don't downplay our feminine side.
Yeah, whatever. Huh, the Wildlands.
A metrosexual paladin. What's that head doing on top of the lance?
What's that zombie head doing there on that lance?
If I put it on the ground, it might try and bite me. It's also much easier to see like this.
I mean, why did you behead the poor zombie in the first place?
Zombies! Are unkempt, stinky, unholy things, without any charm or chic whatsoever.
Chic.
They can't expect any sympathy.
I've spoken to the zombie that you'd stuck in the penitence pillory.
About the zombie you've stuck in the magical penitence pillory.
What about that maggot? Is he going to give himself up to his fate? Is that cowardly zombie finally going to come out here?
He's really sorry for what he did. He'd like to apologize.
Yeah, that's a nasty habit.
Laughable. I'll cut him into little pieces and feed him to the fishes.
Nice. But couldn't you maybe forgive him first?
You've spent too much time in that smoky buffalo's tent. I would never forgive someone like that.
Actually, I've never been there. About your fight with the zombie.
About your fight with the zombie.
That's nothing to do with you. That's between the zombie and me.
That's way off.
About your fight...
That's... and me.
Alright, well, see ya.
Have to go. Man stuff to do.
Ha ha.
Hello.
Woohoo!
I just want...
Hey!
Oh.
Alright, let's head to the teepee then. I was afraid we had to watch him go all the way up there. Huh. A feather headdress.
A hideous feather headdress. No way. I'm not putting that thing on. But I can take a feather.
Well, I didn't tell you to put it on. Just take it.
Still ugly. A single feather from the shaman's headdress. I'd say that the feather comes from a bird.
What's boiling? It's cooking.
The pot looks like it's been hanging over the glowing coals for years. I can't find anything else of interest. Only the lid's unusual. It's got a kind of steam valve on it. The lid is held with a chain. pretty clever. The pot is empty.
He just lets us do all this, huh? It was a mortar and pestle.
A mortar and pestle. Proper, pestle. Man-sized. I think I'd better leave it here. The shaman might get upset if I took it with me. I can always come back if I want to grind anything again. I think I'd...
Metal container.
A copper bowl. No idea what that's good for.
Yet we can take this.
Hey, Chief. Can I take this thing here? Stare blankly if I can. Thanks. A copper bowl from the teepee. It's empty.
Bellows.
A pair of bellows. These would help the bowl keep the fire going. Excuse me. These bellows here. Can I have them?
They are broken.
Can I have them anyway?
What do I get in exchange?
A punch in the face.
Nothing. They don't work.
You speak wisely.
At last, someone who recognizes that. They really are wrecked. There's a hole here in the airbag. The bellows are pretty much past their best. The air can escape through a huge hole in the airbag. The coals are just glowing, but the heat is tremendous. The coals...
Anything else to look at? Campfire, pot, chest here.
Cow makeup.
Cow makeup?
Unless I'm wrong, that is makeup, and I most strongly suspect that it belonged to Big Chief Clovenhoof. Just to make things clear, I'm not putting on any makeup.
I just said take it.
Black ink. I'll take that.
Black ink.
A jar from the shaman's makeup. Full of ink or something. Looks designer.
Designer.
A fat old bull that smokes a crazy-looking pipe. And who doesn't seem to hear me. Or who doesn't get insulted too easy.
Hello?
Hi there. Hello? Anyone home?
Look, look, look.
Moo.
I heard you.
Oh, that's great.
I didn't mean to insult you with that moo.
That moo thing just slipped out. I didn't mean to insult you. I just thought, hey, there's a bull sitting there. I'll say, moo. You get me? If you'd have looked like a donkey, I'd have gone, Eeyore. Or if it stank like a pigsty, then...
I forgive you.
But come to think of it, it reeks of buffalo, and I...
Thank you. I have forgiven you.
Super.
Nate, who are you? And... What are you?
My name's Nate, and you are?
I am known on this plane as Fastfoot, Thunderhoof, or the Rainmaker. I belong to the proud nation of the Minotaurs.
Minotaurs.
And you run some sort of fancy hippie costume business?
I am a shaman.
And that is?
I talk to the ghosts of our forefathers. I brew potions, heal the sick, and invoke the weather.
Wow, lots to do. You must really get stressed out.
True.
So, what are you smoking there?
What's that stuff you're smoking?
Plants. to journey with the spirits and to commune with my forefathers.
You're supposed to eat grass, not smoke it. Okay. I need to go outside. Something not quite right about the air in here.
What's the matter? You're getting
high? Good luck on your journey. May the grass between your hooves be evergreen.
Smoking buffaloes are not to be disturbed.
Let's use the glue on this.
Right. I'll smear the edge of the hole with glue. Just missing a patch now.
Oh, can I use this?
That ought to do it. I'll use a piece of leather to seal the hole. Perfect! The bellows are usable again. The repaired bellows are as good as new.
Now... Well, I guess we don't need to use them on anything. Wonder if you could combine anything. Mix the ink with the paint?
The ink's too good to just splash around. That's finest quality ink for writing, or for painting cows.
Feather. Let's see if anything can be combined with anything. Paint the mushrooms yellow?
Why should I paint the mushrooms?
I have no idea. Oh, crush the red earth in the mortar.
Okay, I'll put the earth into the mortar. And with a bit of elbow grease. Now we have a fine red powder made from the red earth.
We're gonna give this guy a makeover or something with all this stuff?
Now we have a fine red powder made from the red earth.
You put anything else in there? Fasten the pom-pom onto the string.
Nice! Now I've got a pom-pom on a string. The paladin's pom-pom is hanging on the end of the string.
Cook the mushrooms. All right.
Smoking buffaloes are not to be disturbed.
Give the shaman the mushrooms?
Why should I give him the mushrooms?
Oh, no. Like a good idea at the time. All right. Maybe we'll give her a makeover. This will head on up to the orc camp. We'll stop up in here first. Now that I've talked to the paladin.
No idea what I should ask.
Hey, Gulliver.
Ah, the living one.
I've got a first-class lung for you. Oh, made out of the bellows. Cool.
I've got to get going. Breathe. Feel my heartbeat.
Wait.
Sort of thing.
Did I click on the wrong thing?
Don't let me stop you.
I'd better let them keep on working.
Wait, I had that for him. I can't give it to him?
I'd better let...
Ah.
I'd better let...
Sheesh. I guess I clicked on the wrong thing.
This project's not looking all that hopeful, in my opinion.
Alright, let's go. Go to the direction of the orc camp. That's where Wilbur should be. Oh boy. Let's look at this poster. It's pretty intimidating.
Wanted. Slay the gnoll hogger and take his powerful gnoll claw. Blah, blah, blah. All the routine stuff. On the front, there's a weird, wild hog-like being looking at me. The back of the sheet is empty.
Can we write? Mix the paint?
As long as the red isn't liquid, it can't be mixed with other colors.
Ah, okay. It's a rubbish heap.
If that garbage pile grows just a few more meters, the orcs might as well forget the gate. Any attacker will just be able to use it to climb over the wall. Trash from every corner of the world. How did that all get there?
Well, look at this device. Looks like a microscope.
Some kind of juice press, I'd say. You put the grapes or whatever in at the top, and the juice runs out the bottom. Hey, it still works even. Maybe it's just the green-skinned guys who weren't able to work it.
Can I put one of this stuff in here to make it liquid? No? What about the mushroom? Boards.
The boards must have been out in the rain for a long time. They're rotten and covered in mold.
Ticketh. Got a lot of stuff now.
The boards must have been out in the rain.
Yeah. Oh, I got some flowers here.
The flowers seem to be doing well in the garbage. They're in full bloom. The blooms are a luminous blue. Are they supposed to be luring someone or warning them?
Maybe neither.
Great. Now I've got blue fingers.
Got all different kinds of colors, actually.
The blooms are a luminous blue.
I'm gonna put this in there? No? I wonder if we'll put those in the mortar and pestle.
Ah, I don't think so somehow, but we should give it a try.
What do you think you're doing there, worm?
Pushing on this gate.
I'm, storming your camp? Who are you?
I am the great Gorok, chief of the Bloodscythe Orcs.
I like that. The Bloodscythe Orcs. What have you done with Wilbur?
What have you done with little Wilbur?
What's a little Wilbur?
He's a gnome, and my friend.
Oh, him. Since when did people start naming their gnomes? What's the world coming to? He walked into our trap earlier. Stupid little beggar.
Is he all right?
I damn well hope so. What would anyone want with a damaged gnome?
Why do you orcs always have to cause trouble?
Why do you guys always make trouble? You kidnap harmless gnomes and then attack the free world for no reason at all.
That wasn't an attack. It was an anticipated defense of the homeland in enemy territory. And anyway, what else are we supposed to do? We have the biggest army in the world. No one else invests as much gold in the military as we do. It would be madness to invest all that gold and then never wage war.
That's downright irresponsible.
We couldn't anticipate that the damn war would take forever.
And now you're stuck in it up to your ears, as is the Alliance.
That's all propaganda. There are thousands of war-hungry, well-equipped and motivated warriors here in the camp waiting for deployment.
Hmm. Oh, yeah.
I want Wilbur back.
I want Wilbur back. Right now.
Right now.
We caught him, so he belongs to us now. Get yourself a new one.
But I'm responsible for him.
Your problem. He's the main prize in our warrior contest. So he stays here, we're us.
Warrior contest? What's a warrior contest?
What is your warrior contest exactly?
It determines who is the most powerful warrior. Two opponents go head to head in a series of brutal tests. The winner is bestowed with great honor and receives a prize.
And Wilbur's nothing more than a prize to you?
No, the prize is a bottle of fire whiskey. The gnome's just a bonus.
Can anyone take part in the warrior contest?
We orcs fear no one. We'll take on anyone in a warrior contest.
Well, that's fine. Then let me in. I want to take part.
Oh, I said it's a warrior contest. Someone like you taking part would be a complete waste of time.
Is there no other way of getting Wilbur?
Is there no other way to get Wilbur back?
No chance. That thing is the prize for the contest this afternoon.
I could get you another prize. How about a piglet?
No. Everyone in the camp already knows that the gnome is the prize. Sometimes you have to be content with less.
I'm from Environmental Health, and I've got a few questions about this rubbish heap.
I'm from the Environment Office. You do know that you can't just go chucking your rubbish all over the landscape here. Open the gates, please. I need to check your garbage cans.
Do you ever listen to yourself when you speak? How can anyone blather such rubbish?
I don't know either.
It's like I can ask different questions, but every time I select the most stupid one.
If I find myself a warrior, can he take part in the contest on my behalf?
Point taken. I'll go find a warrior in all this wasteland. Then can he take part in your contest?
If he's a real challenge, why not? But not any old piece of rubbish. He has to be a great warrior.
I know where this is going. I'll be back.
And I'll wait.
Well, it's either going to be the Paladin or the Minotaur.
I'd better not speak to him. I want to give him a false sense of security. I'm not going to get in there on my own, but maybe I can as a warrior's coach or technical advisor. I'm just missing a warrior then.
Yeah, really. Hey, you want to take place in a contest?
Hello, princess.
Princess.
Yes.
I'm looking for a warrior to represent me in an orc contest.
You're a paladin, right?
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Paladins know about hammers, swords, and armor, right?
Yes.
Well, you know anyone who's a bit handy with such things? A warrior, perhaps?
I'm very sorry, I don't have anything to do with such barbarians.
About your fight with the zombie.
That's nothing to do with you. That and me.
Right. Have to go. Man stuff to do.
Ha ha.
Yoo-hoo!
I hear you.
Do you have any idea how I might be able to get into the orc camp?
You'll definitely have some smart idea for how I can get into that orc camp out there. Physically, I mean. Not, spiritually or whatever. Thanks for your help. I need to go outside. Something not quite right about the air in here.
Good luck on your journey. May the grass between your hooves be evergreen.
Smoking buffaloes are not to be disturbed.
Oh, what about the flowers? Okay.
Let's see. The blossoms have been pulverized, and what's left is a good blue paste. After their meeting with Mr. Pestle, there's nothing of the blue blossoms left to see.
I'm pretty
All
sure
that's left is an oily, thick blue paste.
Pretty sure it's pronounced Pestle. You can't put that in there.
As long as the red isn't liquid, it can't be mixed with other colors. Yellow and blue make green.
Okay, now I got green paint.
I've mixed the blue and yellow paint, and this green is the result.
Mix the ink with the paint?
The ink's too good to just splash around. That's finest quality ink for writing. The ink's too. Why should I paint the mushrooms? Why should I paint? Why should I paint them?
I don't know, because it's fun. All right. I don't even know what we're doing with that. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Hopefully figure something out. And bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.